Now, see this now. We will discuss about the characteristic of SCR. Characteristic of SCR in the sense, the graph between the, sorry, this is A, anode current, the graph between the anode current and the voltage across anode and cathode. So for different values of VAK, for different values of VAK, what is the value of IA? So that we will draw. And also, see, there is a gate here. Gate current IG is there. It is also a variable one. This resistor is variable, this resistor is also variable. Here, theoretically, you might have studied this thing that I will draw here, whichever you have studied theoretically. Something like this, you will get the graph. Okay. So this voltage is VBB. This case, gate current is zero. Okay. So that part of this graph we are not going to draw. What we are going to draw is that we will draw the graphs for different values of IG. So this is one IG. So I will take this as IG1, IG2, where IG1 is less than IG2. Okay. So here, what is your job is now, first you set the value of IG. So you will do the connection like this. So you will find out in the experimental setup, you find out anode terminal, cathode terminal, gate terminal, you will find out there. Then you have V2 supply, V1 supply is also there. Then you have R1, R2 is also there. And then as for this circuit diagram, you make the connections using the connecting wires will be there, connecting probes will be there. So using them, you connect everything like this. Then what's next you do is that you turn on the supply V2. You turn on the supply V2, okay? First you turn on the supply V2 because you want to give some gate current, that's it. So you turn on the supply V2, then you set the value of R2. Here it is R2, so whichever you call it as R2 or RG, okay? So you call it as, you find out in the setup as R2. So now it's a variable one. So what will happen by varying this, you know very well, here if you apply KVL, V2 minus VGK is equal to IG into R2. So IG value depends upon this voltage difference divided by R2. Okay, so by knowing this difference and R2, by knowing this difference and R2, we can have different values. So this V2 minus VGK, both are constant. You can take both are constant. Then R2 you vary, it's a variable one. Then IG value changes. So for every IG value, first you set some IG value. IG value, you set some current, okay? Any value, if you see in the tabular column, you will find out some 12.5 ampere. So some value, you set some value of IG using this equation. Then now you must, okay, now you set like this. Then after that, you come to V1. You come to V1, you connect the supply to V1 and you turn on V1. Then after that, what you do? You vary R1. So when you vary R1, then obviously you apply KVL here. Then V1 is equal to VAK plus IARR1. You see now. So you fix this V1 if you want, then you vary R1, then definitely VAK, IA, both will vary. So then you note down the readings of all these. So what you require, once you note down this, then you draw the graphs. What you require here is that you need some voltmeters and ammeters, of course, that also you require. So this is theoretically, this is how the relationship between VAK and IA is there, okay? Now you see, now we will see this picture here now. See this picture. In this picture, somewhere you find out SCR. Yeah, here you find out the SCR. Okay, it is written there SCR. See this now. This is your SCR. This is your SCR. Okay, so this SCR, you see, there are the picture which I have shown there. In the picture which I have shown there, there is a gate terminal is there here. This is gate terminal. So these two are anode terminals. Then you have cathode terminal. Now what you have seen in the circuit diagram, there is a gate circuit is there. So to this gate terminal, you have connected R2. So somewhere you must find out R2. Any one resistors you will find out R2. So I will show you here in the picture. You just see somewhere. Yeah. This one is R2. Yes, somewhere you find out here R2. Yeah, you can easily find out when you see the kit, you find out R2 here. These two terminals are R2 here. Now the other one, everything you find out in the kit. Okay, we don't need to search much here. There you find out R1. You see, there is R1 is there here. This is R1 is there here. So this is R1. So R1, R2 are there. So use what you will use here is that use the connecting wires which I have shown last class. Using the connecting wires, you do all the connections as per the circuit diagram which I have shown there. Now what else you require is that you require some voltages. You see, there is a voltage here. There is a voltage here. Now these are the connections. Okay, these are the connections. So V1, V2. So this red one is okay. Red one is not showing here. This red terminals are there. This is positive terminal of the supply. This one is the fuse. And now this is the switch is there. So either you can make it as on or you make it as off. Okay. Once you connect the supply, then below that, what do you find out below this is that there is a rotating knob is there here. So this knob is used to this knob when you rotate that, this V2 supply is there. V2 supply will vary. Okay, so then below that you find out a switch. Once you connect the supply, you turn on this, either on or off. You just use the switch here to turn on the supply. Okay, so is on or off. So whichever you require, everything is there here. There, what is left now here? So as for that connection, you do the connection. Then as for that circuit diagram, then for different values of IG values, you draw the graph between IA and VGK. So voltage and current of the SCR. Then you draw the plot. Then that's enough. Those are called SCR characteristics. Okay. And as part of the circuit, you have some more things also there, how to find out the latching current and how to find out the holding current. I hope you remember what is latching current. Okay, so latching current is related to turn on process. So okay, it is related to turn on. Okay, so it is a minimum gate. It is the current, the anode current, not the gate current. Remember, it is the anode current. So that anode current, holding current is also anode current. Both latching current and holding current, they are anode currents. So latching current related to turn on process, that you slowly apply the voltage or you give the gate signal. So then what do you find out from the graph? From the graph, you find out the anode current slowly increases. When the anode slowly increases, this anode current will reach to a value, and we call that value as latching current. Above that current, you can say the SCR is totally turned on. Similarly, what is holding current is? when you are turning off your thyristor, what do you observe when you turning off your thyristor? Anode current slowly decreases. So once the anode current is slowly decreases, so it decreases to a value, that value you call it as holding current, below which you can call that SCR is totally turned off. Okay. So these values also you can find out from the graphs. Okay. So this is about SCR. SCR characteristics, see here. The experimental kit you will find out there. You do the connections as per the circuit diagram. So you take first one gate current. You take one gate current. For that fixed value of gate current, you vary different anode voltage. So I have shown you in the circuit diagram. How do you vary that? Let's show you once again here. You see this now? So here you vary R1. R1 is there. You vary R1, then it varies IA and VAK using this equation. Similarly, you vary RG or R2. So it will vary IG. So likewise, you will do that. Okay. Now we will see about MOSFET characteristics. First of all, what are the terminals of the MOSFET? You know very well. Gate, drain, source. These are the three terminals of the MOSFET. Okay, so gate and source you will use for controlling. Sir, yes, please.
How we determine, sir, latching current and holding current?
So see, you draw the graph. First you will draw the graph. Yes.
Yes, sir.
See, when you are doing this, see here, turning on process means what do you do now? You will increase anode current. Yes. Turning on process means you will increase anode current. How do you increase the anode current? You will increase the anode current by changing the value of R. Where is that value of R? I will show you here that. Yeah, this is the value of R. So you decrease the value of R. If you decrease the value of R, okay, what will happen if you decrease the value of R? If you decrease the value of R, the voltage drop across this decreases, whereas VAK will increase because apply KVL, then this drop decreases, whereas this drop increases. Okay, then while doing that, you note down the readings for different values of your anode and anode current. You take different values of anode current. Then what do you find out is at one stage, you'll find out the current rises rapidly. In the sense, you cannot even control that. Okay, so at one stage, yeah. How do you find out? That's what I'm saying. That your R1 is there here. So what is your job is now? You set some value of gate current first of all. Once you set some value of gate current, now R1 you slowly decrease. When you decrease R1 slowly, then maximum voltage is applied across VAK. It's KVL. Two values are there, so some potential will be across R1. Remaining potential will be across anode and cathode. So when you decrease R1, obviously this voltage will increase. When this voltage increases, you know the graph like this. Initially, there is a slight increase in the voltage. Okay. You further decrease the value of R1. When you decrease further the value of R1, at one stage, it means this point in the graph. At this point, what do you find out is that here the voltmeter reading, of course, I didn't show you the voltmeters and ammeters. There, see, some display you will find out in the laboratory. I will show you at the end. At the end of this experiment, I will show you. So you connect here you have a voltmeter here, actually. Where do you find out the voltmeter is that? Here you find out the voltmeter. Across this, you find out the voltmeter. Whereas here you find out the ammeter. So you observe the voltmeter and ammeter. Somewhere you find out this voltmeter reading suddenly decreases. This voltmeter reading suddenly decreases. Initially it increases, then after that decreases. Now when the decrement starts, then you see, observe this this value. So you can take an approximate value. You cannot get the exact latching current value. But what is the indication is that the voltage across this anode and cathode will will start decreasing sharply. So it decreases sharply like this. So that point you have to identify. So now you decrease further, you increase the voltage further. So then it is not possible that the voltage will increase, but rather you find out the current starts increasing, okay, sharply. So that point somewhere you can take it as latching current. So only indication is that it increases very sharply. That's it. So that point you have to take. Okay, we cannot accurately catch that point, but the thing is like that somewhere it will increase. Okay, that is one way. Okay, that is one way. So you can follow that way. Now, how do you find out the holding current is now? You disconnect the gate. Anyhow, you know very well that your thyristor is a latching device. So once it is turned on, you can disconnect the circuit. The gate circuit is not necessary here once it is turned on. So you disconnect it. Once you disconnect it, okay, then already some anode current is there. Now you slowly increase the value of R1. You increase the value of R1. When you increase the value of R1, then anode current will decrease. So it starts decreasing. Somewhere you find out that this current will decrease to a very low value. Okay, and after that it becomes zero almost. So there you will find out that the slope you will find out easily. So when you increase the value of R1, you will find out that the IA will decrease sharply, but after some point it decreases slowly. Okay, so practically this is the way how you do that. Okay, increasing the anode current, decreasing the anode current. So somewhere you find out this two points, latching current and the holding current. Okay, we'll go to now. Okay, do
Excuse
you understand?
Me, sir?
Yes, please.
Sir, for changing the voltages, we have no option. Sir, for changing resistance, where we have to change, how to change, sir?
Okay, that's a good question. That, yeah, that's correct. So now alternatively, what do you find out here is that, see, let me tell you one thing. In the kit, okay, we'll show you the kit now. Okay, in the kit, okay, now is this experimental setup is visible?
Hi, sir, visible, sir.
Okay, now you see, I will show you somewhere here that. Say, do you find out any resistance like symbol here? Please tell. Maybe it may not be clear. Yeah. So this symbol is there. So there are two ways. Either you connect this outside any resistor you can connect here. One way is that you connect a resistor outside. Okay. There is second way, I will tell you. What is the second way is that you don't change this value of resistance. Rather, you have this knob is there. There is a knob is there. So when you rotate this knob, what do you find out? This V2 is there here. This V2 is there here. Okay. So this V2 will vary. So here, what is the intention is that whether you vary V2 or whether you connect an external resistance here and you vary that resistance. Okay. In both the ways, your gate current will vary. Okay. I will just show you the equation. So it really does not matter to us what exactly you are varying. Okay, you can follow both the procedures. Now it depends, some batches of students are doing like that, so we cannot say that this is the only procedure. What I'm saying is that you see this equation, which equation of the gate circuit? Please see,
sir?
This equation. Yeah, 1 minute, just see this equation. Ig is equal v2 minus vgk by r2. Yes. So you fix the value of, so what I'm saying is that either you vary R2 or you vary V2. Anyone you do any one thing, either you vary V2 or you vary R2. Practically, when you see in the laboratory, when you come into the laboratory, there you may have the provisions to vary R2 and you have the provision to vary V2. But don't do both. Okay, if you do both, then there may not be change in gate current. Sometimes it remains constant. So anyone you do, for example, you fix everything. You fix R2. Don't do anything with R2. You simply vary V2 by rotating that knob, which I have shown you now. Then IG value changes. Similarly, in this equation also, you fix everything, you change V1. If you change V1, then VAK, IA both will change. Okay, so see, the explanation which I have given here is about varying R1 and R2. If the R1, R2 are not available to you in the laboratory when you do the connection, okay, so then in that case, what you do? You have the chance to vary V1, V2. So our intention is here to draw the graph between IA and VAK. And don't think that you will have only one procedure to do this. No, it's not like that. You have multiple procedures. You will have multiple ways. So that at the end, you will draw the graph between IA and VAK, but different values of IG. So you set a value of IG and then you vary V1, then you will get IA and VAK. Okay, please now. Now question, now what is your question now, please? Yeah, please. What is your question?
So doesn't kit lo leda sir R2 change chesaki provision?
Yeah, there is a provision is there here. See this, there is a provision is there. Now whether the resistors now available or not in the laboratory, okay, that we exactly have to search. We have to search that way, how many resistors are available or not. So if you have the resistors, then we will connect across this, then we vary.
అక్కడ ఇంటర్నల్ గా కిట్ లోపలే రెసిస్టెన్స్ ఉంటది, జస్ట్ బయటకు వచ్చిన టెర్మినల్స్ ఎస్సీఆర్ సర్క్యూట్ కి కనెక్ట్ చేసే కాదు సార్, అట్లా కాదా సార్?
యా, వి కెన్ డు లైక్ సీ, లెట్ మీ టెల్ యు వెదర్ దేర్ ఇస్ ఎ రెసిస్టర్ ఇన్సైడ్. ఓకే, దేర్ ఇస్, అస్యూమ్ దట్ దేర్ ఇస్ ఎ రెసిస్టర్ ఇన్సైడ్. ఓకే, నౌ ఐ విల్ కనెక్ట్. yes, there is a resistor inside. Even then also you connect another resistor here, you vary this resistor, then in that case both are in parallel. When both are in parallel, then resultant resistance will vary. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So in that case also, it is okay. In that case also, it will run. So that's what I'm saying, that see, when you come to the laboratory directly, first you have to check this thing, that whether there is a resistor or not here. Okay, you can do that by using, so you will know the ways how to find out whether there is a resistance. How do you find out whether there is a resistance here or not? Because it is not visible, it is inside something. How do you know? No, it doesn't mean that someone will tell you that whether there is a resistor or not, but being a student in the laboratory, how do you know that whether there is a resistor here or not?
Yeah, multimeter test.
Yeah, you use the multimeter. That's it. That's how you proceed. That you use the multimeter, then you check whether there is a resistor is there or not. Then if you have the resistor, then you will take one way. If you don't have the resistor, you take another way. So. It depends upon what are the things which are available to you in the laboratory. Based upon that, you have to proceed. Now the agenda is simple thing, that you just draw the graph between IA, VAK for different values of IG. Okay. Okay, understood? Yes. Yes. Did you understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, any other doubt, please ask. Someone have asked a doubt that whether R1 is available or not. So V1, V2 also there. So you can vary V1, V2 also in the equation. You can vary V1, V2 in the equation. So then also, so in the, see in here you have V1, V2 knobs are there. Okay, so then see here. There is a knob is there here. Just see this knob. You rotate this. If you rotate this, then obviously your V1, V2 will change. So no problem. Okay.
Sir.
Yeah, please.
Manamu IG ni constant ga 12.5 million teeskunta unnam ga sir.
Yes, yes.
Aa current ke adi SCR turn on aipothunda sir?
See, it depends upon the ratings of the SCR, which SCR you have selected here. Now, the SCRs are available for different voltage, current and power ratings. Okay. Now, I think in the manual, he has given 12.5. Maybe the person who designed this experimental setup, he might have idea about that. Okay. So, it's not like that only 12.5 ampere is enough or not. So, 12.5 milliampere is... So, and this value is not fixed. I told you that this depends upon the ratings of the SCR. You understand now? It depends upon the SCR.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So large size SCRs are there, small size SCRs are there. Okay. High power SCRs are there, low power SCRs are there. So it depends upon the available SCRs. Okay. So I think so. It definitely will turn on. Otherwise, he will not give in the okay, in the manual. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, then we will go to MOSFET characteristics. Okay. So now, first I will draw the circuit diagram. See, the circuit diagram is very same. Okay, except in place of few things, few changes will be there. See, at the end I will show you where exactly means how do you measure the voltage and current. We are saying about the measurement of voltage and current. Okay, so okay, so in the MOSFET, same thing here also, that this is a variable resistance R, this is V1, this is V2. I hope you know this is drain, this is source, this is gate. Okay, so I'm sure that you remember this thing, that your MOSFET is a voltage controlled device. Okay, so voltage controlled device, in the sense you will have different VGS for different values of VGS, means you want to turn on your MOSFET, you know very well that you must give a voltage to your gate and source of the MOSFET, so then only it will be turned on. So if it is turned on, then you have the circuit diagram something like this. Okay, now here in your syllabus, that is in the laboratory experiment, you have two characteristics. One is transconductance characteristics, so this is the graph between VGS, between VGS and ID for different values of VDS. Okay, so the graph will be something like this. This is for VDS1, VDS2. VDS2 is greater than VDS1. So likewise, for different values of VDS, so for example, you take one VDS, then draw the graph between ID and VGS. So how do you do that here? How do you do that here is that, so first you set a value of VDS. In this case, you set a value of VDS. How do you set the value of VDS here? Yeah, now here also you have two options. Either you keep this R value fixed as it is, you keep the value of R fixed as it is, then you vary V1, you vary V1. Then you measure the voltage across this D and S, then you will get the VDS value. For that VDS value, now, then you draw the graph here. So for that VDS value, once you fix this VDS value, then what's next is that vary V2 continuously. So vary V2 in the sense, if you vary V2, the voltage across the gate and source will vary. So for every value of VG, you find out the current here. There is a meter you can connect here. So find out the value of ID. So that's it. So you draw that for all the values of VGS, you note down all the values of ID, then you draw the graph. That's called transconductance characteristics. Okay. So why we are calling it as transconductance characteristics is that what is the slope of this graph? For example, you take the slope here. What is the slope of this graph? Is that y coordinate by x coordinate? Y coordinate is current, x coordinate is voltage. So current by voltage, I hope you know it's conductance. It's conductance. Okay. So that's the name here. You got conductance here. So transconductance in the sense. So the voltage here is VGS, whereas the current here is ID. Okay. Now, another kind of characteristics. The circuit is very simple, okay, but you must know yourself that why it is so, why the graph is coming like this, what is happening inside the MOSFET, that you need to study. Then only you will satisfy with the graphs, okay, why the graphs are like that, okay. So this is drain characteristics. What is this drain characteristics is that this voltage is there, VDS and ID is there. Okay. So for different values of this is VGS1, VGS2, VGS3. VGS1 greater than VGS2 greater than VGS3. So for different values of VGS, okay. So first of all, how do you set VGS? Then in this case, you set V2 a fixed value. Once you set this, don't disturb now. That's it. So then you will get a particular value of VGS. Then after that, what you do now? Either you vary R or you vary V1. Any one you vary, then find out the current here, find out the voltage here. So all the voltages and currents you tabulate and you draw the graph, then you will get this drain characteristics. Okay, what you need to understand here is that, see here, the graph shape. That's what I'm saying, that you need to think of this, why these are like this. Okay, so I believe that we can go through the books which are related to this MOSFET and SCR. So there you will understand why it is, what is happening inside that. Why it is getting saturated, why the drain current is getting saturated. Okay, these things are, so these are the two characteristics you will draw for the MOSFET. So practically what you need to understand here is that I told you this is a voltage control device. That's the reason that for different values of VGS, VGS1, VGS2, earlier you see the SCR, what do you find out in the SCR? For different values of gate current, not the voltage here, please see this now. For different values of gate current, we have drawn the graph here. Whereas here, for different values of gate to source voltage. Okay. So, see, it depends upon the structure of your device, MOSFET or SCR, whatever it is. So, two graphs we will draw here in the MOSFET, the same circuit diagram. One is transconductance characteristics, the other is gate characteristics, drain characteristics. Okay. Now you see the picture here. I will show you some MOSFET somewhere. You will find out a MOSFET. No, it's not a big thing. Even I don't need to show here because once you go to the laboratory, there you will find out yourself. Okay. See, now here you have the MOSFET. This is your MOSFET. Now you see the symbol of the MOSFET here. Okay. So what else you need here? Drain is there, source is there, gate is there. And now in the circuit diagram, you have V1, V2. Yeah, one side you have V1, the opposite side you have V2. Okay. So, and one more thing I will show you here. Just someone asked that whether there is a provision for this R1, R2 or not there. You can connect here. But see here, there is one more thing. It's not visible in the picture. I will tell you. What is this one is? These are resistors R1, R2 vary. You can vary using this. Yeah, I think it's not visible here in the picture. Yeah, you see here when I bring like this, please see this somewhere you find out. R1, R2 you find out easily here. There is R1 here. Similarly, you have R2. You can vary this. See, I don't know how far they are working now. Okay. If they don't work, then use V1, V2. No problem. I think they are not working properly. Okay. See, if you are given a kit and if you have the observation, then there is no use of you to do the experiment. Remember this thing that they may not work or they may work. You have to think alternatively that how can I vary this value? What are the other ways you vary? This is what you have to think. And what is left here now? So V1, V2 is there, R is there. Okay, any one of the resistor you connect, not necessarily only this or this. Any one resistor you connect, then you vary and you draw the graphs. Okay, this is about MOSFET. Okay, now you have any doubts in the MOSFET, you can ask. Otherwise, we can go. We'll go ahead with the next one. Next one, okay. IGBT characteristics. So now IGBT is also a current control device. It's not voltage control, it's a current control device. So these are the terminals of your IGBT, gate, collector and emitter. I hope you know, IGBT has both MOSFET properties and also BJT properties. The power circuit that is across C and E, it is same as BJT, whereas the gate circuit that is same as MOSFET. So your IGBT is a combination of BJT and MOSFET properties. So you have this resistor R. So it is very same as this circuit, its circuit MOSFET. So now first one is transfer characteristics. Transfer characteristics. So this is the graph between VGE and IC. Okay. Yeah, you see here, you will get a similar kind of IGBT MOSFET, you will get similar kind of graphs. This is collector current, whereas this is VGE, gate to emitter voltage. Okay, then you have the graph something like this. I'm sure that this kind of graph you got just now. VCE2 is greater than VCE1. So you fix the value of VCE, it means this one. So you either you vary V1 or anything you vary and you set the value of this VCE. So you will have a voltmeter here. Then you fix this. Once you fix this, then vary the GE voltage, okay, this one, VGE voltage by using this one. Then you note down the readings here. You have the meter here. Okay, so you vary these values of V2, then note down this. So both VGE and IC you note down, then you draw the graph. Then you will get the transfer characteristics. Similarly, you have another characteristics, collector characteristics. Collector characteristics. So this is same as drain characteristics. IC, VCE, yeah, I'm sure that you will get a little bit different graphs you will get here comparatively. VGE1, VGE2, VGE3. G1 greater than VG2. See, one characteristics if you draw, then it's only a matter of time that we just change the connections. Okay, we just change the connections. Then as per the connections you have changed, okay, you see in the lab, you see in the kit whether it is a SCR is there or MOSFET is there. So you just identify that in the kit. You can easily identify the terminals of the MOSFET and IGBT, everything. Then as per that, you just proceed. Okay. So, okay, now we'll go to the circuit. Now you see here, there you find out IGBT. This is your IGBT. Okay. Now collector terminals are emitter terminals, are gate terminal is there. Now you know you require V1, V2. Here your V1 is here, so V2 is this side. Okay, then R, any one of this R you take, then that's what circuit is connected. Nothing else is there. Circuit is connected. Okay. So then as per the procedure which I have explained, so based upon that you just yeah, go through based upon that you just vary the values. And it's very simple because they are not discrete components, they are experimental setups. So when they are experimental setup, then you know, you don't need to work much here. Just doing the connections, turn on, change the values, note down the reading and draw the graphs. Okay, here you have nothing to calculate. Even here you have nothing to, but if you wish to calculate anything else, you can do one thing that you know, you find out the values of this resistance. So then you can calculate theoretically some part. That's it, and nothing else is there. And one more thing is that in the manual, I think he has given the specifications of every device, SCR, MOSFET, IGBT. Just go through the manual. There the specifications he has given. So based on the specifications, you will have an idea that what is this and what is that, all these things. Okay. So now, do you have any doubt in this? Okay. Otherwise, I will show you the last picture. One picture is there. Okay, if you have any doubts, just wait. I will bring that another picture. Yeah, now see this now. Meter unit, it is written somewhere here. See this now. Meter unit he has written. See here, you have four displays are there. See these four displays are there. So this A is, you see V is there here. So it's a voltage, it measures voltage. Then you have A is there here. This measures current. Where this milliampere, it measures the current in milliampere, this voltage once again. So you see here, this is a device or this is a setup which can measure the, that's what I said just now. I told you that you need some voltmeters and ammeters. So based on that, whether the current is in ampere or milliampere, so you connect that. So you have two terminals. Very simple, that for these two terminals you connect them. That's it. Okay, then this device will measure the current. So this device has 2 ammeters and 2 voltmeters, and the values will be shown in the display. Okay, so then you connect the wires here. Okay, this is the meter. Okay.